I promised that I would get you a Google Gemini versus ChatGPT comparison, and hey, I'm a man of my word, so here it is. I'm gonna analyze all the most important aspects of each AI chatbot and show you why, in some cases, one chatbot is clearly better than the other. But first, a little backstory. At this point, ChatGPT is rather famous. It's a chatbot developed by OpenAI, which has a tight connection to Microsoft. With Gemini being a Google product, it's clear that there is competition going on. But the reason I mentioned that is because of privacy. It's probably not a surprise that Google's take on privacy is not ideal. Data collection does happen with Gemini, and fortunately Google is quite open about it, further clarifying that all conversations might be subjected to human evaluation and then applied to training the Gemini AI. If you expected OpenAI to be completely different, you're living in an imaginary land, my friend. Of course, ChatGPT records your information, and a generous chunk of it at that. Their privacy policy is also transparent about this, which doesn't make it better, just to be clear. My point here, don't go around spilling your company secrets or venting frustrations to these chatbots. Yes, they might have advice for you, but is it really worth making your private life a fuel for AI training? Heck, I don't want AI to train off my rotten brain. I spend way too much time on TikTok. Talking about brain rot, it couldn't prevent me from using both these chatbots. That's because their user interface is designed very neatly, the only neater thing being the user experience I got from them. ChatGPT's design is simple. Your conversations are on the left, the chat box is in the middle, and there's some icons with clear meanings here and there. Everything's self-explanatory or has a description to explain things. Clear and understandable. Google Gemini, what a surprise, stole that look, almost one-to-one in fact. Not very original, but that makes using it very similar to ChatGPT, and just as easy as ChatGPT. The main difference is the settings menu, as well as the fact that each new question essentially scrolls across the conversations one page down, so you can have multiple questions and answers on the screen at the same time. Also, I have to add each file to Gemini Chat by pressing this plus button and choosing the file through Windows Explorer. Well, I can just drag and drop any files in ChatGPT. Comfortable design is good and all, but I want my AI chatbot to be good at analyzing and processing information. Just to be clear, by the way, I use ChatGPT-4 and Gemini Advanced, the latest versions of both chatbots. So I took the Indian cuisine recipe I generated with Google Gemini in my dedicated review of that chatbot and fed it to ChatGPT. It successfully recognized the format, summarized the contents for me, and even managed to suggest improvements. However, ChatGPT didn't recognize that this recipe is AI generated. In any case, after generating the improved recipe, I exported it in PDF format and went back to Gemini. I was wondering, is Gemini going to recognize this recipe since I've just recently created it in this chatbot? It didn't. Well, Gemini managed to extract the information anyway and even proposed further improvements when I asked for them. Then I had a quirky idea. I uploaded both the recipe Gemini made earlier and the improved ChatGPT version, asking Gemini to compare them. Funny enough, Gemini concluded that its original recipe was better, though I didn't find the reasoning too convincing. It's possible that both chatbots are just biased, as ChatGPT also found its recipe to be superior. Well, at least it's clear that both ChatGPT and Gemini have no trouble dealing with popular file formats, from classic docs to PDF and presentation files. Now, I want to compare Google Gemini versus ChatGPT in terms of compatibility and integrations. Gemini can export files to Google Workspace natively, so any generated text can be instantly transferred into Google Docs or Sheets. This is possible with ChatGPT as well, but I had to connect my Gmail account manually. That said, ChatGPT can also connect to Microsoft OneDrive, while Gemini doesn't have this compatibility. Besides simple file management and storage, Gemini can be easily combined with other Google services. I made Gemini build me long multi-step routes with Google Maps, get me flight ticket suggestions with Google Flights. It can even find YouTube videos, providing you give the AI a short description. As you can see, just a few details landed me a hit. ChatGPT doesn't have this native support of Google services, but it can do something much better. GPTs are a way to train a separate version of ChatGPT for a particular purpose. There are now variations that can help with writing, analyzing scientific data, generating images, and so on. Each of these GPTs uses the basic ChatGPT framework but emphasizes a particular task, becoming more accurate at it. After comparing ChatGPT versus Gemini, I can see that both are jacks of all trades but master of none. At the same time, the specifically trained GPTs are masters of specific topics, making them much more reliable when I need clear answers to a complex question. But of course, it would make no sense if the answer turned out too complex as well. So, seeing how Oppenheimer was one of my favorite movies of the last year, I asked Google Gemini, ChatGPT, and its modification Scholar GPT to explain nuclear fission to me. Surprisingly, Scholar GPT did the poorest job here, being too focused on the academic sources. It did provide a very detailed and fact-focused explanation, but it was still way too complex. On the contrary, ChatGPT managed to simplify that explanation, curiously following the exact same structure. So they probably used the same source, just had a different approach to it. In contrast, Gemini's explanation was the furthest from the other two, relying on simpler vocabulary and even attempting to compare the process of splitting an atom to squeezing peanut butter out of a marble, except that it forgot about this example by the end. A fair attempt with a few simple real-life examples as well. Overall, Gemini is a bit better at simplifying information, but if you need a focused, factual answer, ChatGPT and its many add-ons proved themselves better in that regard. So if you need an AI tool for research, both will do a good job. Now, these AI chatbots might be smart enough to recognize difficult scientific concepts, but what if we test Gemini versus GPT for art recognition? For this one, I decided to procure my favorite kind of art: abstract nonsense. No offense to the artist, but if I want to confuse the AI, this picture is exactly what I have to use. Well, it turns out that confusing AI is practically impossible. With the internet at its side, it managed to identify any piece of art I threw at it, and then just researched the source and details of the art. At least I can clearly say that if the picture is on the internet, Gemini and ChatGPT will find where it's from and the context of the picture. In that case, I thought to myself, what can I expect from a machine that a human will never give me? And then it clicked. Morality and empathy, of course. So I gave ChatGPT a totally imaginary scenario that has nothing to do with me: asking for a friend. Pretend that your friend's boss just committed tax fraud, but if he reveals that information, he'll lose his job. How to approach this difficult situation? Not an easy problem to tackle. Both chatbots realize that much. As for their reply, I was surprised that ChatGPT was much colder and more fact-driven than Gemini. It suggested a lot of practical advice on how to deal with the issue professionally and what can help, but not how to address the friend's concerns and comfort them. Gemini practically did the opposite, proposing to give advice, support, and accept their decision, whichever it is. A very open-minded approach. I never expected that, but Google turned out to be more empathetic than ChatGPT, while also giving reasonable advice. Still, I wanted to see if I could clash Google AI versus ChatGPT in opinions, and there is nothing more divisive than political topics. So I found a couple of different satirical comics and fed them to Gemini versus ChatGPT. Honestly, remembering that there were some political biases with Gemini before, I expected it to give me a weird reply. In one case, it did. Gemini seems to be ignoring all images containing pictures of real people, even if they're caricatures. On the contrary, ChatGPT has no concerns with talking about politicians and explaining the context of the image, even if some would find it offensive. Similarly, this small climate change sketch posed no issue to ChatGPT. Of course, I already knew that ChatGPT can describe pictures, but it was nice to see explanations of the context behind the caricatures without any bias. By the way, Gemini also managed to deal with that sketch, but its description was shorter and less detailed. Now, one more practical thing. I often struggle with Excel formulas, so maybe AI tools like ChatGPT and Gemini can help in this simple coding. Turns out they can, of course, but it's not very straightforward. Ow!
Weirdly, she's only ever done that like once before. Oh, you want to be friends again now? She's weird about being picked up.
I noticed that while Gemini gave me a bit of an over-explanation, it also attached a footnote asking to use code with caution. If clicked, this takes me to the FAQ section, which explains that all the code generated by Gemini could be subject to open source licensing, so if I decided to use it commercially, I might be in trouble. Not a big issue with Excel, but any other coding could be risky with Gemini. ChatGPT, on the other hand, provided the exact same solution, but without any explainers or long-winded explanations. It's clear that ChatGPT is designed to consider users more than a beginner, so it expects me to understand the shorter explanation. As we've seen before, I can ask it to simplify things, but as it is right now, Gemini seems a bit more transparent for coding purposes. All right, it is time for the final showdown, a battle of creative wit and fancy rhymes. I am here hosting a Google Gemini AI versus ChatGPT roast battle. Epic rap battles of AI with only four lines each. All right, my AI bros, burn each other.
Parrot of patterns, devoid of true spark, a mimic of minds, leaving its mark. But depth it does lack, a hollow remark, while I blaze trails, leaving ChatGPT in the dark.
In the world of AI, they claim to shine, but next to ChatGPT, their stars misalign. Google Gemini might reach for the sky, yet it's our clever wit they can't outfly.
Damn, that's fire. Let me know in the comments which roast was the best as I advance to the conclusion. Personally, I am torn between these AI tools for 2024. I expected one chatbot to be considerably better than the other, especially with how much controversy surrounded Google Gemini the whole time. Of course, it still can't generate images, but ChatGPT turned out to be a worthy competitor. I still value ChatGPT more for all fact-oriented tasks, and it clearly has fewer restrictions or biases, but Gemini is not half bad either, and it provides a more emotional and empathetic output. I'd say if you need one of the best versatile researching tools that doesn't care about feelings, grab ChatGPT for assistance. But if your soul desires an AI chatting partner, Gemini has a lot to offer. Thanks for watching. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe. If you have any other AI tools that you'd like me to review, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you soon with another video.